Viruses like influenza that causes flu, RSV that causes bronchiolitis, and parainfluenza that causes croup, we're seeing really low rates of those viruses this year. And we think that's related to a few different reasons. One is many of these viruses are transmitted in the same way that the SARS coronavirus type 2 is transmitted. And so the measures that we are recommending people put in place to decrease their risk of getting COVID-19 also help to decrease the transmission of these other viruses. As a pediatrician, in our hospitals in the middle of January, usually we're seeing many children admitted with influenza infection or with RSV infection. And this year, we're really not seeing that at all. The rates of hospitalizations, the rates of positive tests for those infections amongst children have been extremely low, which is fortunate because those infections cause a lot of illness and deaths within the pediatric age group. In this past year, we have also seen the highest uptake of influenza vaccine than we have ever seen before. And so close to 200 million doses of influenza vaccine have been distributed. And that certainly has helped to also keep the rates of influenza infection low this year. And I think it's still really important that everyone follow the recommended preventative strategies that are recommended for COVID-19 prevention, which also help to prevent against acquiring influenza. And we really have to see kind of what happens over the coming weeks and months. The flu season can go as long as May. And so there's still quite a few months ahead of us to see kind of how things go. Interestingly, when we look at the experience in the Southern Hemisphere, for example, Australia last year also had a very mild flu season during their typical winter respiratory season. But they're now starting to see, starting in December, some increase in cases outside of what would be their typical influenza season. And so we're looking at that with some interest to see whether this phenomenon that we're seeing may end up just delaying our usual flu season or maybe not have one at all this year. I think it's too early for us to say for sure.